Hi, my name is Juan Perez Wheeler, and I attend the Harvest Cathedral campus. I was blessed to be born in a Christian home. My parents are the ones who I'll credit to introducing me to Jesus. I met Tracy Moore, my wife, back when we were in college. I'm an architect and I produce workplace design. In 2011, my work demanded that I move to Chicago.
Listed our house and it sold so fast. That was that, there was no going back.
Moving to Chicago was a dream come true. Chicago is as good as it gets for architecture in the United States. On my first day, they took me to introduce me to our new top leader. And she basically saw me and gave me a sweep with her eyes up and down and said, "This is not what I thought he was gonna look like," and she left. About 6 months later, she offered me a demotion. I was given two options. One was to go back to Texas, where we had come from, or take the option of just being demoted. I didn't want to do either.
We're bewildered. We are not quite sure where this is going. We only had 2 days of temporary housing left, and we were going to start a lease on an apartment. I wasn't bringing in any income at all, so he decided to actually take the demotion.
For the next 7 years, things were not going well at the company. Difficult boss, difficult business partner, difficult environment, difficult work. I had been pulling all-nighters like crazy for a very long time. My job demanded me to travel. There was bullying going on.
One of the ladies said, "Well, your English is just horrible. And if you don't improve your use of the English language, then you're gonna have to leave." And we thought, this is just wrong.
When Tracy, my wife, would drop me off in the morning at work, I unfortunately wouldn't want to get off the car. It was that difficult and that poisonous.
And me as a wife, or even as a mother, and someone's attacking my family in a powerless way, I would reach out to God and say, I can do nothing for my husband to protect him from this, but God, you can."
Having my small group was a life changer. There was one night when Chris, my small group leader, and the rest of the small group laid hands on me and they prayed for Jesus to move that mountain. And shortly thereafter, I got fired. The last day at my job, I actually remember walking out of that building with a big smile on my face.
So we waited on the corner outside waiting for him to come home, and just welcomed him home and gave him a humongous hug and lots of love.
7 year trial, terrible ending, and now no certainty where things are going. When I left the job, I was ready to get the next job, but God was showing me he was not ready to give me that job. Everything I was pursuing was a no.
Waiting's tough because You don't know where your next paycheck's coming from.
We would all of a sudden panic, like, "Oh my gosh, look where we are. How are we gonna pay this? How are we gonna get that insurance? Our kid got sick, how are we gonna pay for that?" In the book of Matthew, Jesus is walking on water, and the minute the very real wave starts lapping you and they're cold and they're violent and it's dark, if you look back up to Jesus, you'll be fine, and that's all you need to do. He is sovereign and he has a plan, and we just need to be faithful and just basically just chill. The next 3 months, he completely restored us.
It was the first time he could rest for a long time.
The Lord makes you lie down in green pastures. I went to volunteer at church. There were a lot of people asking for help and prayer for a difficult career situation. We did a little get together in the summer, just spend time praying for each other, exchanging tips on job seeking, just being there for each other in company. There was one precious day in which Pastor Ed was preaching at church, and he just mentioned something about maybe all along you were just asking God for something for you, but the whole time he just wanted you to want him. The whole time I had been asking, "Give me some of your power so that I can get back this material, who cares thing that I want so desperately. I'm letting go of everything. Take me where you want me to go, Jesus.
That evening, he came across one of the jobs, and we had never heard of this company before.
And it was actually for a financial services company, of all things. But it just so happened that the job description matched everything I had. Tracy and I were comparing things like medical insurance, every single thing, as we compared item by item, everything was better. He's not a god of prosperity, but he's a god who will definitely meet your needs as opposed to your wants. There was one morning we were taking our kids out for a surprise.
They thought, he's gonna take me to the donut store.
And we missed the exit to the donut shop. They started crying.
Papi, you didn't drive off the freeway, you missed the store.
Of course, we had a different surprise for them.
He was actually taking them to go on a trip.
Their favorite travel destination.
For us as adults, when you think about that, you can be asking God for a donut and he wants to do something else.
Not only way better than I was thinking, but something I didn't even know to ask for. 1 Peter 5:10. After we have suffered a little while, he will restore us, he will strengthen us, and he will establish us. God delivers on his promises. You will actually be thanking him that he took you through every single difficulty you went through. It's true. I know that to be true. That's my God. That is Jesus.